want. Before starting this lectures, I would like to thank Indian Pharmacists Association who provide me this platform to deliver the lectures. The members of Indian Pharmaceutical Association, Harvinder Kamalji, Nitesh, Abhay Kumarji, Bupinderji, Dr. Arun Koda, Charul Rajiv, and Professor Bajwa also, and Dr. Khurana and other members. And moreover, I would also like to thank the management of Lala Lajpat Rai Group of College, Director cum Principal Professor Bajwa, Vice Principal Mr. Sachin Goyalji, and other my colleagues, faculty members. So the topic that I have chosen today, that is pharmacovigilance and ADRs. And my dear students, my dear colleagues, ADRs is the sixth leading cause of death nowadays. And if ADRs occurs, and peoples are suffered from different disease. So the first episode that was occurred in 1937, when the particular company that is called as Mason Gill dissolved antibacterial drug sulfonamide in ethylene diglycerol. This ethylene diglycerol make this elixir is sweet in taste, and sulfonamide is antibacterial drugs. But the company has failed to test ethylene diglycerol for its toxicities, and this ethylene diglycerol cause renal failure, and 107 children are died as a result. So another happened like thalidomides that is marketed by German firms, that is Camigranuthel. This drug was used for the pregnant women, and this drug was very safe during experimental animals for safety during pregnancy. And the ladies take these drugs during pregnancy for the problems of vomit. But as a result, the severe fetal disconformities are formed, and teratogenicity occur approximately 10,000 babies was born. Kisi ke haath nahi hai, kisi ka toh nahi hai. So that was the problems was occur, and then there is development of pharmacovigilance. So there are different societies, different in every country has their pharmacovigilance department. So now, according to pharmacovigilance, first of all, we should know what is medicines. So medicines are used to treat disease by relieving alerts, physiologicals in the patients. Medicine hum de rahe hain patients ko. Patients ko koi problem hai, he is suffering from pyrexia. We have given the paracetamol to the patients, pyrexia se relieve karne ke liye. Because thanks for watching different the students. One from Dr. Farizana, she is a clinical pharmacologist from Pakistan. Rishabh, Lalit, Sunil Yadav, Bhavna, Raj Jasmeet. So if we are given the drug produce the therapeutic effect. One is pharmacokinetics, another is pharmacodynamics. Mera bahut sara ek question hota hai mere students ke sath, you have wear the lab coat, aap lab coat pehen ke you are moving outside the city, or on the way aapko ek buzurg lady mil gayi. She told, beta, I have headache, I have taken some painkiller mere stomach ke andar gayi, aur mera sar dard kaise theek ho gaya. As a medical professional, we should know how drug will be act. So as a pharmacist or as a pharmaceutical persons, we should know, agar drug hamari body ke andar gayi hai, to ye different receptor ke saath bind karegi, receptor ke saath bind karke response show karegi. So drug development process by there are different process. One is INDA, that is investigation of new drug applications, when we know that these particular chemicals are responsible for particular disease, we use this drug. Another is NDA, that is new drug applications. After that, post-marketing surveillance was occurs. During post-marketing surveillance, Rofecoxib drugs was very good effective as in NSAIDs, or coxib receptors pe ye bind kar rahi thi. 13 December 2004, these drugs are withdraw from the market because cardiovascular problems was occurs. Immediately these drugs are withdraw from the market. So in 4000 before Christ, the first record of euphoric effect of poppy. 2000 before Christ, ephedrine, pseudoephedrine was reported to cause tachycardia, hypertension, sulfonamide, I have already discussed, thalidomides also discussed. So when adverse effects was occur, that is any untoward medical occurrence that may present during treatment with the pharmaceutical product, but which does not necessary to cause the relationship with the treatment. Again, one example. We have given anti-tuberculosis drug rifampicin. When we dispense this drug to the patients, the urine color will be red, the patient taken the rifampicins. So sometimes patient think कि मेरे urine के साथ blood आ रहा है अगर वो rifampicin drug ले रहा है. So as a pharmaceutical person, we should guide to the patients, uncle, auntie, Mr. Miss, अगर आप ये rifampicin drug ले रहे हो, इस drug के लेते ही color red आएगा, but it is not a blood, it is excipient effect. So as हम लोगों को guide करना पड़ेगा. कुछ adverse factor that is recommended, हमें पता है. The patients who are taking NSAIDs, the patient who are taking narcotics drugs, constipations होने का problem है. The patients who are taking nitroglycerin, headache होने का है. That is recommended. हाँ, ऐसे होगा. कुछ ऐसे हमने penicillin देने के बाद patients को allergy आ गई. That is not recommended. So हम ए इसकी रिपोर्ट आगे की आगे भेजनी पड़ेगी. सो एनी रिस्पॉन्स टू ए पर्टिकुलर ड्रग इज नॉक्शियस अनअटेंड विच अकर एट अ डोज नॉर्मली यूज इन मैन फॉर प्रोफाइलेक्सिस डायग्नोज थेरेपी ऑफ डिजीज और मॉडिफिकेशन इन साइकोलॉजी फंक्शंस इज नोन एज ड्रग. सो ऐसे कौन से फैक्टर हैं जो एडीआर प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं? वन इज एज, जेंडर, डिजीज, रेस, एलर्जी, इनअप्रोप्रिएट डोजिंग, मल्टीपल ड्रग थेरेपीज, प्रेगनेंसीज, इनएडिक्वेट पेशेंट नॉलेज. सो एज, हाउ एज विल बी इफेक्ट? मोस्टली एल्डरली पेशेंट कंज्यूम 34% ऑफ मिनिमम ड्रग्स. Elderly patient are suffering from many disease. He is suffering from diabetes, he is suffering from hypertension, he is suffering from cardiovascular disease. Whenever he is suffering from many disease, he taken the maximum drugs. So adverse drug reactions are among the top in 5 threat to the senior's health. So prolonged to suffer ADR with diuretics, hypnotics, antihypertensive, psychotropic agents, that is effect on the during the age. Even recently, yesterday I just read one topic, that is the persons who are above than 65 years, he must not take an amoxicillin. Very common drug amoxicillin. Or किसी के antibiotic की जरूरत है, डॉक्टर amoxicillin लिख रहे हैं. और हम as a OTC भी इसको कई बार लेना start कर रहे हैं. But amoxicillin, the patients who are above than 65 years, if we have given the amoxicillin to the patients, nephrotoxicity will be occurs. अगर हम एज की बात करें, चिल्ड्रन की बात करें, तो neonates have poorly developed enzyme system that involved in drug mutations, excretions, leading to alert drug handling. So children are more prone to develop ADRs due to increased enzyme activities. Like aspirin, aspirin cause Reye syndromes. Lamotrigine, that cause rashes. Even metoclopramide, that cause extrapyramidal side effect in neonate or children. So in gender, if we think about the gender, and women appears to be more suspected to ADRs than male, because there are hormonal change, there are more adipose tissues or hormonal influence. So that's why some ADRs are more common in women as compared to male. Intercurrent disease, like patient is suffering from cardiovascular disease, renal disease, liver disease, they have more alerts to drug handling. The patient who are suffering with HIV, there are 99% chance for tuberculosis. It means his immune system is very weak. So HIV positive patients are more prone to ADRs. Genetically means drug metabolisms that are subjected to genetic variables like acetylations, oxidations are more important to cause ADRs reactions. Like the patient, the persons who are living from Africa, HIV-1 will not act on that persons. HIV-2 will be acted. The patient or persons are living in Africa's because to genetic morphisms. Even though there is more deficiency of glucose 6-PD, that is for African, occur in Africans, that is hemolytic anemia occurs in Africans. That is due to the oxidation, certain enzyme oxidation agents occurs in Africans. So that particular, that is hemolytic anemia will be occurs in that type. Allergy. The patient, immunoglobulin E is very effective, that is present inside our blood cells. If immunoglobulin E is more than the particular quantity in our blood cells, that cause the allergic reactions. It means the persons or patients having more immunoglobulin E, the allergic will be occurs more. Inappropriate dosing. Difference of pharmacokinetics parameter due to change of drug compositions, pharmacological conditions. Inappropriate. We have given the drug to the patients, he forget to take the medicines. After that, he just realized the medicine bhool gaya, he's taken more drug as compared to first dose. So as a medical professions, people, we should guide to the patients. भी आपने अगर ये ड्रग लेनी है तो इस ड्रग को अगर आपने मिस कर दिया है तो डबल डोज नहीं लेनी, अदरवाइज एडियाज विल बी अकर्स. मल्टीपल ड्रग थेरेपीज, दैट इज पॉलीफार्मेसीज. वन पेशेंट्स विजिट टू वन डॉक्टर्स, ही इज नॉट सेटिस्फाइड टू पर्टिकुलर डॉक्टर्स, देन ही अगेन विजिट टू अनदर डॉक्टर्स, डॉक्टर change the brand name but the genetic compositions was the same. So patient took the double dose and ADRs occurs, that is correlate between increased number of drugs, likelihood occurrence of ADRs. Another prolonged therapies, that is if drugs, some have habituals in our country, I have headache, aapke paas पेनकिलर है, पेनकिलर को ऐसे खा रहे हैं जैसे आफ्टर अ फूड सॉफ्ट खा रहे हैं. कॉम्बी फ्लेम वेरी कॉमन, हल्की सी दर कॉम्बी फ्लेम्स. सो देर इज इंक्रीज इंसिडेंस ऑफ एडीआरस. नसेड्स इंड्यूस गैस्ट्राइटिस, एंटीबायोटिक इंड्यूस डायरिया, ओरल हाइपोग्लाइसमिक एजेंट्स कॉज हाइपोग्लाइसीमिया. इफ दे हैव इंक्रीज द डोज or increase, the incidence will occur. Some drugs that cause the teratogenicities, like harms to the babies when taken during pregnancy. So some physiological change during pregnancy may affect drug dispositions, causing reduced effectiveness, leading to dose-related adverse effect. Inadequate patient knowledge. Inadequate patient knowledge. मेरे सिर दर्द है, मैंने आई हैव टेकन डिक्लोफेनिक. मेरे साथ वाले के सिर दर्द हुआ, उसने भी सेम डिक्लोफेनिक. विच डिडंट नो द पेशेंट इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम कार्डियोवेस्कुलर डिजीज, ही हैज टेकन द नाइट्रोग्लिसरिन टैबलेट. नाइट्रोग्लिसरिन से उसका दर्द, सिर दर्द हो रहा है, उसकी वजह से है, या उसको बाहर साइनस प्रॉब्लम है या अनदर प्रॉब्लम्स है. देर आर मल्टीपल रीजंस बट वी हैव टेकन द सेम ड्रग्स एट अवर कोलीग हैव टेकन. सो देर इज अनइन्फॉर्म्ड पेशेंट सीरियस बट प्रिवेंटेबल पेशेंट्स रिलेटेड रिस्क फैक्टर विल बी अकर्स दैट डेवलप द एडियाज. सो एजुकेटिंग द पेशेंट्स अबाउट देयर ड्रग थेरेपी कैन बी प्रिवेंटिंग मिनिमाइज एडवर्स इफेक्ट. पेशेंट्स को कैसे एजुकेट करना, जैसे आई हैव जस्ट गिवन वन आइडिया लाइक रिफेम्पिसिन. अनदर, इफ वी हैव गिवन द एंटी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस ड्रग टू द पेशेंट्स, एंटी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस ड्रग्स टाइम पीरियड वॉज 6 months to 12 months. पेशेंट्स हैविंग सिम्टम लाइक द टेम्परेचर इज 99 degree एंड we have dispensed the isoniazid, rifampicin, ethambutol, pyrazinamide, streptomycin, these drugs to the patients. First day he just taking these drugs aur usko relief hona shuru ho gaya, theek hona shuru ho gaya. Har koi sochta hai why should I take this medicine again. Agar wo medicine nahi le raha, mycobacterium tuberculosis again occurs to the patients and he is again suffer with TB. So as a pharmaceutical persons or as a pharmacy persons or as a medical practitioners, we should guide to the patients, ye 6 month ka courses hai, isko aapne continuously lena hai. So kuch aise side effect hai jinke bare mein hame pata hai, jaise agar koi tricyclic antidepressants drugs le raha hai to usse dry mouth hoga, we should guide to the patient, ha isse ye problem aa sakti hai. ओपेट्स ले रहा है तो कॉन्स्टिपेशन आएंगे. अगर सल्फोनाइल यूरिया ड्रग्स ले रहा है, सल्फोनाइल यूरिया अगर डोज ज्यादा हो गई है तो हाइपोग्लाइसमिक पेशेंट्स होगा. दैट इज अगुमेंटेड, दिस इज नोन एज अगुमेंटेड साइड इफेक्ट. एंड सम इफेक्ट इज बिजारे, दैट इज लाइक एनाफिलैटिक रिएक्शंस ऑफ पेंसिलिन. पेंसिलिन गिवन्स टू द पेशेंट्स, एडिमा विल बी अकर्स. ए प्लास्टिक अनिमिया, the patients who have taken chloroamphenicols, amphenicols drug. So another, that is side effect. So there is unwanted but often unavoidable pharmacodynamics effect that occur the therapeutic dose. Patients ko humne therapeutic dose di, par usse hi kuch unwanted effect aa gaya. So they are not generally serious, but they can be predicted from the pharmacological profile of the drug. Like atropine cause dryness of the mouth, some patients. Promethazine cause sedations. Glyceryl trinitrate cause postural hypotensions in some patients. That is a side effect. Secondary effect, that when indirect sequence of primary actions of the drug, like suppression of bacterial flora by tetracycline. Tetracycline, as a pharmacist, again, tetracycline is never given with milk because chelating. Tetracycline never given with the calciums. Tetracycline again given with iron. Iron, because tetracycline and if irons are given in combinations, chelatings will be formed. That is a questionable mark. That is not given in combinations. Again, I will discuss one examples. Gynecology department, one doctor written a prescription iron tablet to a pregnant woman. That is very common. Iron tablet is compulsory for. Patients has complications for acid problems. And doctor written the antacids. Whenever we receive the prescriptions, our pharmacist, clinical pharmacist just asks, sir, this is a wrong prescription. I just went to the doctor. Doctor, this is a wrong prescription you have written. Doctor again, I'm a doctor. How can you say this is a wrong prescription? For iron metabolisms, we required ulcer. If we given the antacids to the patient, ulcers is diminished and iron is not metabolized, again the baby inside the wombs will be anemic. That's why iron and antacids are not given. Another is, we have given anticholinergics and levodopa in the treatment of Parkinson's disease. Both because levodopa we have given, dopamine level should be minimized and acetylcholine level be low by anticholinergic drugs. But if we given both these drugs, anticholinergics and levodopas, the epidemiology concern of aseptic, that is particular demoralization, demoralities will be occurs to the particular patients. So that's why they have not given together. So toxic effect that result excessive pharmacological actions of the drugs that occurs due to overdose, even though prolonged use, that produce the toxic effect. Like morphine, if we given to the patient, morphine cause the respiratory failures. Imaprin, if we given the drug, that cause the cardiac arrhythmias. Another, if we given the large dose by taken, the patient's taken the large dose, it result the poisoning. Any drug is poison. So poison is a substance which affect our vital function, COAT, industrial chemical or insecticides. The persons who are walking in industry, they have taken some chemicals by doing a walk. The persons who are walking in the fields, insecticides will be occurs that cause the poisons. So some characteristic toxic effect of drugs individual at the therapeutic dose also. Like trifluoropromazine that induce muscular dystonia. Few dose of carbamazepine cause ataxia. Carbamazepine, if they, even though therapeutic dose, the patients having the problem of ataxia, like movement, just like a drunker. So there are abnormal reactions occurs, like barbiturate cause excitement or even mental confusions if drug is given to a normal person. Chloroamphenicol produce ataxic anemia in the patients. It means drug wrecked with some unique features of individual or prolonged uncharacteristic reactions occur. Kaibar, whenever we do the patient counseling, I visit to different countries, and whenever I visit in different, I have visited 14 times out of India. Or jab bhi main jata hun, I not only deliver the lectures, I met to the pharmacy department also and doctors. They have their common patient counseling department. In patient counseling department, 7 minutes are given to a clinical pharmacist with counseling with the patients. If you are not satisfied the patients in your degree, there is time unsatisfactory pharmacist. In that 7 minutes, you can discuss about what is, you have any drug allergy. You will guide to the patients about the doses, how will you will take these dose. Like it should be taken at bedtime or it should be taken on empty stomach. So some patients have allergy. That is, even smaller dose have different time occurs, onset and durations of attrition. So drug allergies are occurs mainly on skin, airways, blood vessels, blood or GIT tract. So persons are having photosensitive, they just walk on the sun rays, allergy will be occurs. UV radiations act on particular skins because they are very sensitive, skins was very sensitive. So phototoxicity will be occurs. Means drug or its metabolite accumulate in the skin, absorb light, undergo photochemical reactions followed by photobiological reaction resulting local tissue damage. And local tissue damage, drugs like Dapsone, nalidixic acid, D-merc, cyclosine. Another is photoallergic. What is photoallergic? That is cell-mediated immune response, and which exposure to the light for longer waves length of UV. If we take like